Hello everyone, in this video let us understand how to perform scoop disconnection from the cluster nodes. This is the agenda. Scoop is a Hadoop based adapter that would help in importing data from relational database sources into the HDFS and process it and then load it back to relational database sources. So the scoop jobs can be run in Spark, Place and Hive mode. The Hive mode is deprecated. It is recommended to use Spark and Blaze mode. To confirm if the scoop connectivity to the database and the tables is working fine or not, we can use the scoop import utility from the cluster nodes and test the connectivity. The default scoop client library location in the Hadoop data node is, as mentioned in the slide, for Hortonworks and for the Cloudera cluster. So if you are using Cloudera cluster to run your pushdown mapping, then you can go to opt cloudera parcels cdh lib scoop lib location, and you need to place the JDBC driver or the jar that you are using for the scoop jobs. This jar you might have placed in the InfraHome external JDBC jars. You can copy the same jar to the cluster node in the respective location. If it is Cloudera, you need to place in the opt cloudera parcels cdh lib scoop lib location. If it is Hortonworks, you need to place it in user http current scoop client slash lib location. So these are the steps to test the scoop externally from the cluster node. You need to log into any one of your Hadoop data node where you have the scoop client installed, and we need to copy the JDBC, the database specific JDBC jar file to the scoop client home lib location. In the previous slide, I have mentioned the scoop client lib location for Hortonworks and Cloudera respectively. And we need to get the scoop import command from the mapping log and run it from the data node. So this is a knowledge base article which explains how to perform the scoop connectivity from cluster nodes. So you need to copy the jar to the scoop client home slash lib location, as I mentioned before, and you can run any command from there. So the generic scoop import command is like this. The first argument is the JDBC URL. The second one is the DB username, the database username. The third one is the database user password. And hyphen hyphen verbose is to enable verbose logging whenever we run the scoop import command. And hyphen query is to mention the query or the star from the table or any other queries that you want to run. The target dir is used to mention the HDFS path to which you want to import the data from the table that you have mentioned in the scoop import command. So before we see how to run it from cluster node, let us see our scoop connection from the developer tool. So this is my scoop connection. This is the username and you can get the password. And this is the driver class. And this is my connection string. And the scoop connection string is here. And I have enabled verbose logging. So whenever we perform disconnection from here, it uses the connection string that we have mentioned for the connection string option. So we will not understand whether the scoop connectivity is working fine or not. So we need to perform scoop connectivity from the cluster node to understand whether the connectivity to the database is working fine or not. So this is my cluster node and this is my Cloudera cluster. So I have navigated to opt cloudera parcel cdh lib scoop lib location, and I have placed the respective JDBC jar, the OJDBC6.jar over here. So now let us perform the scoop import from here. So this is my scoop import command. I've used the same connection string that I have mentioned in my connection, which I showed from the developer client. I have enabled verbose logging, and this is the username password. And this is my table name and this is my target location, and you need to mention the split by the column name. So let me run this command. So this will generate, or it will create a MapReduce application. Now let us see whether this MapReduce application created by this scoop import command works fine or not. Okay. So this command failed because this path already exists. Let me change it to another location and run it again. So it has created a MapReduce application. So this is the application ID and this is the job ID. Now let us see whether it runs fine or not. So if the database connectivity is working fine, then the MapReduce application should run successfully. As you see here, it completed successfully. So now we can say that the database connectivity is working fine. So now we can say that the database connectivity is working fine. So we can use scoop connections to import or to export the data. So that is it for the demo. If you have any feedback, you can write us through @supportvideos@informatica.com. Thank you.